Well, good morning, everyone. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with a look at the Canadian stock market for Thursday morning. In the pre-market this morning, things are fairly quiet. Stock index futures are right around fair value. Natural gas and crude oil are higher, while gold is slightly lower. Let's start off this morning's presentation looking at the Canadian dollar. Looks like we've run out of steam here up at the 80 cent level. We came down to the lower channel line yesterday. Did not close below it, but it looks like we're trading under that level this morning in the pre-market. So we may end the day on Thursday with a short-term sell signal for the Canadian dollar. Looking at the U.S. dollar index, made a new low yesterday. Remember, the U.S. dollar index is the U.S. dollar against a basket of currencies, including the Canadian dollar. Next up, let's take a quick look at the U.S. market. The VIX has been elevated over the past couple of days, but it has not changed the trend. The trend is still to the downside. That elevation has not come from the Dow, which hit a new all-time high yesterday, has not come from the S&P 500. It has a lot more to do with what's going on in the NASDAQ, which has seen some extra volatility and pressure, downward pressure over the last couple of days. One area I'm keeping a close eye on is the transports, and that has been selling off of the last couple of weeks and is coming down towards the 200-day moving average. In regard to the Canadian market, of course, there's a couple of big railroads that operate in the U.S., Canadian National and Canadian Pacific. Both of them are on sell signals right now, but it looks like the market is more interested in getting back into Canadian National than Canadian Pacific at this time. Next up, let's take a look at the commodities, and starting with crude oil. Crude oil has given us an early warning signal this week. It's also given us a bearish engulfment day, having trouble breaking out above the $50 level. It traded down to the upper channel line over the past couple of days, but certainly not a lot of weakness there. Just a little bit of a concern at the moment. Close, of course, below 47.48 would give us a sell signal on Thursday, and it doesn't look like we're heading in that direction in the pre-market. Natural gas inside day yesterday, it is up slightly in the pre-market this morning, but not looking for a change in trend on Thursday. Early warning signal up there for copper, stuck, having trouble breaking out above the 288 level. 293 is our next daily target. It's also our next weekly target for copper. On the downside, we need to close below 280 on Thursday to give us a sell signal. Not expecting that to happen from what we're seeing in the pre-market. Gold had an inside day yesterday, silver inside day, and no change in trend for those two commodities expected on Thursday. Moving over, looking at the Canadian stock market, starting with the TSX, we're back above the upper channel line once again, still on a buy signal, no change there. Most actively traded stock on Wednesday was Bombardier. It looks like a new high for Bombardier for this move. Looking at the energy sector, looking at the index, it looks pretty calm. We had an inside day yesterday, but not everybody's moving in the same direction. Encana closed lower yesterday, and we'll go through based on volume from Wednesday's trading action. We need to close on Thursday below 1224 to give us a new daily sell signal. Looking at Cenovus, closed at the upper channel line yesterday. It closed below 987 would give us a new sell signal. Next up, we're looking at Spartan. Spartan, second day of a sell signal there. Looking at Crescent Point. Crescent Point traded through the lower channel line yesterday but did not close below it. Actually closed higher on the day. We need to close on Thursday below 949 to give us a sell signal there. Not looking for a sell signal for Baytex, and certainly not looking for a sell signal for Suncor, which made a new high for this move on Wednesday. Looking at the gold sector, we had an inside day on Wednesday, but once again, not everybody swimming in the same direction right now. The most actively traded gold stock on Wednesday was B2 Gold, a new low there. New low for the second most actively traded gold stock, Eldorado. We had traded in the channel yesterday for Kinross. A close below 511 would give us a sell signal on Thursday. Inside day for Barrick, no chance of a sell signal on Thursday. Looking at Semafo, new sell signal based on Wednesday's closing price. No change in trend for Guyana Goldfields. And last up, looking at Yamana, still on a buy signal. A close below 312 would give us a sell signal on Thursday for Yamana. Let's finish off this morning's presentation looking at financial services and the banking world. The financial services index generated a buy signal yesterday. The equal weighted banking index did not. What's not working right now, the TSX group itself, we need to close above 67.90 to give us a buy signal on Thursday. And Home Capital, which I believe came out with earnings this morning, we need to close on Thursday above 14.42 to give us a new buy signal there. What is working in financial services? It's the insurance stocks. Intact was up sharply yesterday. There we've got Manulife and Sun Life doing very well. And last up this morning, National Bank is the big winner in the banking sector at the moment. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Looking for a fairly quiet open on Thursday. Have a great day, and the next time you'll hear my voice is on Sunday.